It's my birthday. Hi Pixies, my name is Gigi. If you haven't been here before, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today is my 21st birthday, and I thought I'd just do a little get ready with me and like talk to you guys while I get ready because I want to spend part of my birthday with you. So yeah, that's what we're gonna do. I do have a pretty recent makeup routine on my channel, so I'm not gonna like super go into depth about what I'm doing, but I will link everything below. So today's video is actually sponsored by Dossier. So thank you so much, Dossier, for sponsoring this video and all of you for giving me these amazing opportunities. So let's talk about Dossier. These are the perfumes that Dossier sent me. I absolutely love both of them. First of all, this packaging is so pretty. Dossier perfumes are super, super cool because they are a much more affordable option than like designer perfumes, but they're still super high quality and also all smell like designer perfumes. Every scent is either $29 or $39 for the niche ones, which is very affordable for such a high quality perfume. Designer retail prices for perfumes usually range from like $50 if you're lucky to like $280. So this is good. What I really love about this company is it's all cruelty-free and clean ingredients. The perfume industry can be really damaging, and also oftentimes it's not cruelty-free. So it's incredible that these ones are. They're all crafted in Grasse, France. So that's really cool. You know exactly where they're coming from. They're all also paraben and phthalate free, colorant and UV filter free as well. All of their scents also like mimic a designer scent that's already out there. So if there's a designer scent that you love, but it's like too expensive to purchase, they probably have it on their site with their own ingredients. So for example, I have the scents Oriental 2 and Woody 1. So Woody 1 is compared to YSL Mon Paris or Mon Paris, which retails for $97, and this one is $37. It has Vermont, raspberry, strawberry, middle tones of jasmine, orange blossom, pear, and patchouli, white musk, and cedarwood. I absolutely love this one. It smells so fresh, but like musky, which I love musky smells. Oh my god, this one is intoxicating. This one smells so good. Top notes of almond, middle tones of iris, jasmine, tuberose, sandalwood, and then get this, base tones of coffee, tonka bean, vanilla, and cocoa. So this one, this is my favorite. It smells so good. This is literally what I want to smell like all the time. This is my new favorite perfume. I feel like a goddess when I wear this one. This one smells, I'm pretty sure, like, yeah, Carolina Herrera Good Girl Eau de Perfume. This one retails for $105 for 1.7 ounces, but this was so much cheaper. So yeah, you have free returns or exchanges on all of their perfumes. They oftentimes also have amazing bulk deals to like a 25% off discount and free shipping when you buy three or more bottles. They're always adding new scents to their website as well. But yeah, overall, I love this company. I think they're really cool. The packaging's beautiful. It's amazing. They're cruelty-free, vegan, and clean products. So you can actually get 10% off your order with my code GG10. So make sure you do that, and I'll also leave a link below. But yeah, okay, continue on with the video. So my boyfriend and I are long distance, so I can't spend the day with Frankie, who I know you guys love, which I'm very, very sad about. I wasn't there for his birthday either. So yeah, long distance sucks, but you know, it is what it is. We're making do. What I am doing today is I am meeting up with two of my best friends. I'm meeting up with them, and we're gonna do a little picnic. I'm so excited. I literally have a picnic basket that my mom gave me. So like, it's gonna be legit. I'm very excited. And we're gonna meet at like this local grocery store, and I'm gonna pick out some like rosé or something there because I can buy it now. Which, can we just talk about that for a second? That's insane to me. Super weird. I remember like was so far away and like being like, oh my god, and thinking like 21 is so old. Whenever I have a birthday, I get kind of really sentimental, but every single year I try and like right before midnight, I try to reflect on the year before. So like last night I was like thinking about 20 and the things that were special to me in the year of when I was 20, which were, for me, I'm not gonna share all of them, but like some really cool ones were when I started school and I had that whole experience of being like a student of, I have so many good memories of my boyfriend and I this past year. And then quarantine happened. Not my finest moments, honestly. Quarantine really sucked. I'm not very proud of how I acted for a lot of quarantine. I was quite the brat. Quarantine sucked. My YouTube really started to pick up in my 20th year, which was so exciting. I feel like I just figured out how to be more natural in front of the camera, really produce like content that I feel really good about and really excited about. And then I also like try to think about like things that I really want for this next year. My goals for this next year, well, I really want to hit 50K on YouTube. We're almost there. If you're not already subscribed, subscribe. We're so close. And that like literally rocks my world. Like I feel so incredibly grateful for you all and for this community we've built and just for like YouTube in general. It just is something I look forward to every single week and like what I feel so excited to do. And I never get bored of editing videos, or I never feel like, oh, I have to do this. It never feels like that because I just genuinely love doing this so much. It's been so fun like expanding and trying new styles. Like my last video, I kind of tried a new style and I think you guys really liked it. So I'm gonna try and do a little bit more of that and incorporate some stuff that I'm learning in film school into my videos a little more with like cinematography wise. Because I am a film student, so like why not incorporate that stuff? I just want you to know how much I love you and how grateful I am for you. I want to feel really content in my friendships and my relationship and my like relationships to everyone, not just romantically, just like relationships, like with my family, with my friends, with my boyfriend. I just want to feel content and like I just want to make people happy and bring joy to other people's lives and just people in general. Like you guys, I want to bring joy to your lives and to your days. What else? I really want to travel. I know travel is kind of, you know, iffy right now. I wanted to go to Europe so bad this year. I wanted to go to Paris. I'm also like, I'm feeling the New York pull again. Maybe it's just cause like we can't go there right now. I mean, you could, but like I'm not going to. But I'm like really sad about it. I watched this, I think it was by Vogue. Had Whoopi Goldberg that was narrating it, and it was just like this thing about New York. I feel such a pull in New York, and when I lived there, you know, it's hard. It really is hard living there, and I think that I was really young, and it wasn't. I lived in Midtown, I danced in Midtown, and I worked in Midtown, so I basically never had time to get out of Midtown, which can be exhausting because, as you know, Midtown of New York is like where Times Square is, Columbus Circle. Like it's a really hectic, busy, stimulating area, and I just can't handle that. Like I just couldn't handle that. But now I know that, and I think other parts of New York, like really anywhere else, I just absolutely adore and could see myself being really happy in. I kinda just really wanna focus this year right now on working and just really grind it out with YouTube. I also really wanna feel more content with school and feel more content about what I'm doing there. I've kind of been thinking about switching my major because, I don't know, I've just been kinda thinking about it. And I do really like teaching. I have had some experience, mostly with like, never with like academic teaching, but I've had experience with like teaching dance and teaching, been like a choreographer for a couple of kids, like musicals and stuff. And also my mom runs a bunch of girls education programs and I've always helped with those. Like I've been helping with those for years and it's like some of the most fulfilling stuff in my life. Even though sometimes it's frustrating and sometimes I'm like, oh my God, like kids, I don't know. Just a thought. I really like online school. I know this is a controversial topic, but I actually love doing school online because it feels like a good balance for me. It feels like, okay, like I'm still getting the degree, I'm still doing the college thing, but I'm doing it in a way that works a lot better for me and my schedule and makes me feel like I can still get other stuff done. None of my roommates are in the apartment. I've been singing and I've started to realize like how much I miss singing and theater. Since New York and since like dancing in New York, I've had a little bit of a just confusing relationship with dance and musical theater and all that, and just trying to figure out like what I want. I was a late starter for dance. I didn't start like ballet and stuff until middle school, which in the ballet world is considered late. And I think I had kind of a really damaging, traumatic experience in high school and late middle school with dance that kind of really traumatized me and ruined it a little bit. I had a dance teacher that I looked up to so much, and in probably like my sophomore year of high school, I went into her studio with my mom, and we were gonna have like a meeting with her. I was starting to look at colleges. Actually, this must have been junior. I was starting to look at colleges and trying to decide like what I wanted to do. And at that point, I still kind of was thinking about possibly going to school for theater, musical theater and dance. And we were talking about like dance programs of the summer I could do and stuff. And just wanted her advice. Basically told me to just give up. And she basically was like, I don't think any of that's gonna happen for you. I'm gonna be honest with you. You don't have a dancer's body and you should just call it quits. I think you should put your energy into other things. And that was so damaging to me as a 16-year-old girl. I was in classes with girls who were a lot younger than me because they had all started dance earlier and I had started late, which also was just kind of not good for my self-esteem, like as a growing 16-year-old girl. It just made me feel very incompetent. I don't know, just had a lot of damaging effects, I think. And because of how these teachers would treat us and how this one teacher especially would treat me in relation to the other kids. Because I was older, which makes sense, but at the same time it was damaging, and they'd say very rude, mean things like, these 12-year-olds can do it, like why can't you? Like stuff like that. It's just damaging. I had like a fear of going to class and a fear of dancing. And it's something I still have and I still struggle with. It's why I haven't been to class in over a year. Don't love going to lyrical classes. I don't love going to hip-hop classes. I don't love that stuff. I don't love just dancing. I think when I do find joy with dance though, it's when it's in addition to theater and acting and singing. I think possibly the solution to this problem is combining dance with theater and singing, because I had a hard time going to dance classes, but I never had a hard time going to show choir or when I was in musical theater shows, going to those shows. And when there was a dance part, I felt at home. I felt so vibrant and so like in my element. And it was something that brought me so much joy consistently. So I think maybe I'm just putting too much pressure on myself to go to dance classes and be a dancer. I know I'm busy and I know it's Corona season. I'm not saying I'm gonna try and be in musical right now. No, I think it would be really cool to not stop singing and not stop acting a little and dancing when it's combined with these things. Or maybe even just finding a dance class that's fun and it's no stress. Anyway, bringing it back to the singing thing, it's just I've been finding so much joy with singing here when I'm home alone. I really want to sing more this year. Did I tell you all about 11:11? Every single day, I see 11:11. It's amazing. I asked you guys in one of my last videos about it and like what it means. And a lot of you said it means that like the universe is manifesting. It's like manifesting your goals and your dreams. Ah, I really hope that's true because that'd be good news for us. Okay, my face is done. I literally have eyeshadow all over me because it broke. Okay, well, I'm gonna go wash my hands and then we have to do my hair. Yeah, thanks for listening to me rant. I'm gonna do my hair in a second, but yeah, I think this year I just really want to focus on my goals and really feel successful in my goals and my aspirations, and you know, feel really happy and content and make people happy, bring people joy, spread positivity. This is not what I imagined my 21st birthday to be like, but I think that there's so much to be said for just finding the joy in little things and finding the joy in, you know, the simplicity of what this is. I don't think that like we need to be trying to make right now what it used to be, because right now isn't what it used to be. Right now is something that we've never experienced before, so why are we treating it? I don't like when people are trying to act normal when this isn't normal. And that's okay. Like, we should adjust and change to what this is and, you know, find a ways to make the new best out of our new normal. And I struggle with this too, but I think when I am trying to do that more, I feel more content and I feel happier and I just feel better. So, yeah. But yeah, find the joy in the little moments. Find the joy in the little moments. Like today, I think it's gonna be, even though it's not the extravagant 21st birthday I imagined, it's gonna be really nice. I'm gonna spend it with my family. I'm gonna see my best friends. It's gonna be great. Smell of 21. Princess Polly. My hair, this is actually a really good hair day. I have this little purse from Depop that I got, my gold necklace, some gold earrings. I'm just wearing these little sneakers to kind of make it a little bit more chill. Okay, my friends are waiting for me, so let's go.